Today on Island Focus, you will enjoy meeting Dr. Patrick Sullivan, who is founder and CEO of Oceanit. Happy you're with us. And we are very grateful you took the time to share with us a little bit about what you do and your vision for Hawaii.
Thanks.
So Oceanit is an organization you founded quite a while ago.
We call it a mind-to-market company. We think of things in deep science from fundamental concepts and drive it to impact humans and society. So we really cut across a lot of disciplines from aerospace to ocean sciences, biology, healthcare, information systems. We think that by putting to work science and developing the engineering solutions, we can actually make a big difference.
You also work in the community, though, the
right.
community. So how does that interface with the technology and all the research that you offer?
We look at it, the community as it's our ecosystem, right? So, I mean, nothing happens in a vacuum. We have to move together. And we're at Oceanit building a tech industry, but that means everybody participates. And so we're active in the schools, we're active in the environment, we're active across the board because it's our community.
So when you say you're active in the schools, for instance, are there projects or programs or folks?
Yeah,
that go
there's
into
a
the
there's a really cool thing we're doing. I'll try to keep it short, but it's called Altino. It's an experiment to get kids to learn coding by teaching teachers how to code with little robotic cars. We started out with non-STEM teachers, so history, social studies, and others. And the teachers are excited, so the kids are excited. And now we have a plan to educate 5,000 teachers and 200,000 students.
So you mentioned in our previous conversation about sustainability and resiliency. How does that interplay with your vision for Hawaii?
Well, the climate's changing. There have to be ways to deal with it. We can either be a victim and complain about it, or we can try to think through how to do something. And so starting with coastal areas, resilient, sustainable coastlines is how we have to think. So it has to be long-term. It has to be community-focused. So everybody wins. You have to really think about not just humans as well, but what are we doing to the ecosystem so that we're not losing the environment that we love that makes Hawaii so special.
Are there specific areas that we might recognize in the projects that Oceanit has been involved?
Gosh, 15, 20 years ago. I remember in Lanikai, we were asked to look at some of the coastal erosion. And so I tried to get everybody together and say, if we treat this as one coastal area and everybody works together and we have the state and others work as a team, we can do something.
So
but that was ignored.
Everybody meant state, county, residents,
right.
organizations.
And getting people to work together, if we could have done that, my view is that we could have preserved the beach. It's gone, mostly gone.
Hmm.
So I think it's a hard lesson. Now we're looking at other things today, and I think people are paying attention because that's how we're actually going to have a sustainable coastal ecosystem. And we have to look at it as stewards as well. So, you know, there's a thing we worked on, which now people are interested in. This is, gosh, 15, 20 years ago too, a roving sand mining crew. You know, nobody thinks that you got to have people clean up in the parks and you have trash crews. What if we create a crew that goes around and nourishes beaches just on a regular basis? It's just part of what they do. And they go out and there's sand that gets lost offshore. They bring it onshore. And this is done on a recurring basis every year. We maintain and protect the beaches.
This is one of your ongoing projects or one of the visions you have?
Well, we actually put this together as a design concept almost, gosh, over a decade ago. I think it's almost 20 years ago. But now we're talking to the resiliency group at the city, and they're very interested in new ideas.
So maybe it was premature in terms
yes.
of people's willingness to change, but definitely its time has come.
The time has come, and it may manifest in a slightly different configuration, but we can do more. And people here, we know the ocean, right? People know the coast, the ocean, so we're not strangers to this. We just need the charter to take ownership to do something.
Well, thank you very much for spending a few moments and explaining not only what you do, but also what you know is possible for Hawaii.
Thank you.
Thank you. We've enjoyed conversing with Dr. Patrick Sullivan, who is founder and CEO of Oceanit. Happy you're with us.
Thank you.